Okay, now I don't want to alarm anybody in this room, but it's just come to my attention that the person to your right is a liar. Also, the person to your left is a liar. Also, the person sitting in your very seats is a liar. We're all liars. What I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you what the research says about why we're all liars, how you can become a lie spotter, and why you might want to go the extra mile and go from lie spotting to truth seeking, and ultimately to trust building. Now, speaking of trust, ever since I wrote this book, Lie Spotting, no one wants to meet me in person anymore. No, 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 no. They say, it's okay, we'll email you. I can't even get a coffee date at Starbucks. My husband's like, honey, deception. Maybe you could have focused on cooking. How about French cooking? So before we get started, what I'm going to do is I'm going to clarify my goal for you, which is not to teach a game of gotcha. Lie spotters aren't those nitpicky kids, those kids in the back of the room that are shouting, gotcha, gotcha, your eyebrow twitched, you flared your nostril, I watched that TV show, lie to me, I know you're lying. No. Lie spotters are armed with scientific knowledge of how to spot deception. They use it to get to the truth. And they do what mature leaders do every day. They have difficult conversations with difficult people, sometimes during very difficult times. And they start up that path by accepting a core proposition. And that proposition is the following. Lying is a cooperative act. Think about it. A lie has no power whatsoever by its mere utterance. Its power emerges when someone else agrees to believe the lie. So I know it may sound like tough love, but look, if at some point you got lied to, it's because you agreed to get lied to. Truth number one about lying, lying's a cooperative act. Now, not all lies are harmful. Sometimes we're willing participants in deception for the sake of social dignity, maybe to keep a secret that should be kept secret, secret. We say, nice song. Honey, you don't look fat in that, no. Or we say, favorite of the digerati. You know, I just fished that email out of my spam folder, I'm so sorry. But there are times when we are unwilling participants in deception, and that can have dramatic costs for us. Last year saw $997 billion in corporate fraud alone in the United States. That's an eyelash under $1 trillion. That's 7% of revenues. Deception can cost billions. Think Enron, Madoff, the mortgage crisis, or in the case of double agents and traitors like Robert Hansen or Aldrich Ames, lies can betray our country, they can compromise our security, they can undermine democracy, they can cause the deaths of those that defend it.